Hello dear students, welcome to the lecture series on immunology, and today we are going to discuss about the third line of defense, and in particular in this lecture we'll talk about the humoral immunity. So when we talk of this third line of defense, unlike the other lines of defense, that is the first and the second line of defense, third line of defense is more evolved, more versatile, and more targeted or specific type of immune system. Now that is why it has been said as a smart system. It is also specific and adaptive in the way that depending on the type of antigen or the pathogen which one gets exposed to, our body actually decides that which kind of assassin or which kind of defense system is to be activated and activated particularly in terms of killing that particular pathogen. Now after this specificity, the next thing which is important in the case of third line of defense is the memory response. And when we say memory response, it means, we have discussed this before also, that it is actually the on exposure to the same antigen the second time, our body generates the heightened response, because we already have saved B cells or T cells activated in activated form, so that the response which is generated on second exposure is of quite high intensity. So we can say that the non-specific immune system is like simply the warriors with the little knives or the very basic weapons with them. But when we talk of the third line of defense, this is more specific, and this we can say they are like the warriors or the assassins with the highly sophisticated instruments, the machine guns and the other recent techniques and technologies with them. So this is more advanced rather. So there are two types of specific immunity, that is, one is the naturally acquired immunity, another one is the artificially acquired immunity. Now when we say naturally acquired, means during our daily life we encounter number of different types of antigens, okay, and depending on the type of antigen, our body actually responds to it. So this kind of immunity is known as naturally acquired immunity. Now another one is artificially acquired immunity. See, it is actually simply the case in which it is artificially induced to us, right? Like the response to the antigens which are introduced through the vaccines. Now see, it is not the case that our body is responsive to the entire the foreign invader. Like in case of bacteria, it is not that the whole bacteria is responsible for generation of immune response. So that immunogenic component can be either some of its component, like its cell wall, the capsular structure, the pili, flagella. So that means, this indicates that the entire organism is not responsible for the generation of the immune response. So these immunogens can be some of the components of these foreign invaders, be it the bacteria, fungi, protozoa or viruses. Like in case of viruses, they could be actually some of its capsular proteins, that is a nucleocapsid proteins, which is responsible for generation of the immune response. And similar is the case with the other organisms. Food and dust can also be antigenic to us, and they enter only, see, this third line of defense gets activated only if the first and the second line of defense gets breached. See, like in the whenever there is a cut in the skin of the mucous membrane, that leads to the entry of these pathogens inside our body, or by direct injection such as with the bites of an insect or with the needle also. Now this could also take place through actually the organ transplantation or by means of the skin grafts. See, remember this, that anything which is foreign to us will lead to the generation of immune response. And when we talk of the organ transplants, because these organs are transplanted from the other individual, so they are sometimes treated by our body as a non-self. Okay, so again this could be the source for the generation of the immune response. Now this specific or adaptive immunity, it has two components. The first is the humoral immunity, or another one, second one is a cellular mediated immunity. When we say humoral mediated immunity, in this the major player is actually the antibodies. So it is also known as antibody mediated immunity. Now in this case, the major cell which is involved is the B cell, which arises in the bone marrow, but it activates also in the bone marrow. Now this B cell on activation or on exposure to any antigen gets converted to the plasma cell, and these plasma cells are basically the effector cells which produces the antibodies. Next immunity type is actually the cellular or the cellular mediated immunity. This is also known as cell mediated immunity rather. So in this, the two the major cell which is involved in this is the T cells. Now depending on the type of receptors which are expressed on their surface, they are known as the CD8 plus T cells or CD4 plus T cells. So CD8 plus T cells are also known as the cytotoxic T cells, that is they are involved in the direct cellular killing. Now another T cells, that is CD4 plus T cells, are also known as the T helper cells. So they are involved in recruitment of other immune cells, means they are not involved in the direct killing of the pathogen, rather they employ other components of the immune system to kill that intruder. Okay, so this is the structure of a B lymphocyte or a B cell. See, you can see over here, it is a simple cell with the antibody bound structure. Okay, this is a typical monovalent antibody which is bound to their surface. Now this process whereby the receptors get expressed on the surface of these cells, it is known as their maturation. So this is a fully mature B cell. It expresses a unique antigen binding receptor on its surface. So we can say the B cell receptor is a simple membrane bound antibody molecule. That means this antibody molecule is specific for a particular type of antigen which it can bind to. So this is the general process of formation of the B and T cells. This we have discussed earlier also, that by the process of hematogenesis in the liver and the bone marrow, these pluripotent stem cells, they get converted to lymphocyte stem cells, from which these B cells and T cells are derived. Now the B cell gets matured in the bone marrow itself, and that is why it has been given the term B cell, whereas the T cells, they then migrate to the thymus where they get activated, or they actually express out the receptors, and that depending on that it becomes the T cells. So if it is the CD4 plus receptors, then it is the T helper cell, and if it is the CD8 plus receptors, then it is the cytotoxic T cell. Now next term which is important is actually the activation of B lymphocytes. Earlier we discussed about the maturation of B lymphocytes. Now we are discussing the activation of lymphocytes. See, before going into it, there are certain there is a term that should be known to you. So the first is actually the naive cells, and the one is the activated cells. See, I'm using the term cells because these could be either the B cell or the T cell. So what are naive cells? Naive cells are those cells which have never encountered any antigen. Okay, now activated cells are what? Activated cells are the one which have actually, which encounters any antigen and gets activated to produce its response. So this term should be you should keep in mind. So activated B lymphocytes, you can see over here, this is the simple B cell with the antibody molecule on its surface. That means it's a mature B cell. Now when this B cell comes into contact with any antigen, or when it actually recognizes any antigen and binds to it, it gets activated. Okay, now this activation could be either by direct conjugation of this antigen onto these B cell receptors, or it could be indirectly by means of the T helper cell. I told you that the T helper cell, they recruit other components of immune system to produce the response, right? So here the T helper cell, they actually on activation, they produce certain cytokines which in turn activates the B cell, and then it gets activated. After the activation, it could follow either of the pathway, either it the half of this actually enters into the memory response pathway, and another one actually enters into the effector cell pathway. Now when we say the effector cell, means they get converted to the plasma cell, and then these plasma cells then produce the antibody molecules, whereas the memory cells, they keep this in mind that this pathogen has been previously encountered, and then depending on its frequency of actually encounter, it then produces the type of response. So this is the general overview about the humoral mediated immunity. See the animation, I'm not able to play on this lecture, but I have included this or attached this as a separate file, and you can play this at the end of the Moodle app in the lecture series on the immunology. There you can see that how it actually works. So this red colored component is actually the antigen molecule. Now when this antigen it binds to a specific antibody molecule present on the B cell, then what happens is that this B cell will get activated. Now after activation, this entire component of the antigen gets internalized. This is not being shown over here because the animation is missing, but I'll show you like this. Like antigen gets internalized, then here the proteases present in the B cell, they convert this antigen into the smaller fragments, and you are aware that not the whole part is immunogenic, only a smaller component or certain component might be immunogenic. Now then there's certain specific receptors which then bind to these antigens, and then they are upregulated. Okay, this is the combination of actually the antigen and the receptor molecule that has been upregulated. Now this is the component which then actually binds to the T cells. See, I have told you that the T cells cannot directly bind to the antigen molecule directly, rather the antigen molecule has to be presented to them like in a silver platter so that they can bind to it, right? Now this receptor antigen combination with the B cell, where the B cell serves as the antigen presenting cell, so this then binds to the T cell receptor through the MHC complexes, certain complexes I'll tell you further. So then this T cell gets activated, and on this activation it releases certain cytokines. With these cytokines, they further control certain other pathways, the cascade of reactions, whereby they produce certain receptors on the surface of these cells, or rather we can say they produce a signaling pathway, and then which converts these B cells into the plasma cells, which are the effector cells that produces the antibody molecules. Now then these antibody molecules are released into the biological milieu, where they then bind to the circulating antigen molecules, recognize them, and then kill them. Okay, or it might send them to some other associated pathway of the immunity to directly extrude them out of the body. Now next important feature is the clonal selection of B cells, right, on antigenic stimulation. See, you can see over here that there are number of variety of B cells which are there with the different antibody molecules on their surface. That means this if we consider this B cell as the A type, this as the B type, and this as the C type, and so on, this as the D type. So each will have the different types of and the receptors on their surface. That means they can bind to the different types of antigen molecules. Now when an antigen enters into the body, it actually specifically binds to the particular type of the B cell expressing a particular type of the antibody molecule. For example, here this antigen binds to the D type of B cell. So immediately the signal is sent, and there is an immediate proliferation of only this D type of B cells. So there is an immediate proliferation which will follow the two pathways, first to the effector line and another to the memory line, whereby the clone of such plasma cells will be produced to produce the type of antibodies which will specifically bind to these intruding antigens, and for another line where the clone of memory cells will be produced. See, all this takes place. See, the formation of all these B cells, the different types of B cells, takes place during the embryonic development stage. Okay, so this process is known as a clonal selection, whereby the B cell is selected which is specific to the antigen to be bound, and then this is being proliferated to produce the increased number of the antibody molecules which can then bind to the these antigens and extrude them out of the body. See, another important component which is actually associated with the humoral immunity and which is very important, that is apoptosis. Apoptosis is actually a process of programmed cell death. And whenever this, that means every cell it actually follows certain cycle, okay, right from its birth to actually its growth and then to the end. So all the cells, they must die. So whenever this programmed cell death gets disturbed, it leads to a condition called cancer. So this programmed cell death is involved in the various stages, like in the case of morphogenesis, where the organs are being formed. Like you can see over here, this is the hand structure, and these are the extraneous cells which have to be removed, and these are removed by means of the apoptosis, and this is the entire hand structure, right? So this is involved in the morphogenesis. Then next is actually in case of the selection. See, you can see over here, for example, if you want to select such cells which will bind to this membrane, so these are the two cells which can actually bind to this membrane. So the process of apoptosis actually works in such a way that they will remove such cells which are not able to bind to this cell surface. So again, the important work done by the apoptosis is the selection or elimination of the non-functional cells. Then another one is actually in, this is primarily important in the case of immunity. You can see over here, these are the cells and these are the self antigens. Self antigens means the antigens, self antigen means which are a part of our own body component. Okay, so these cells are the one which recognizes the cell antigen. See, what will happen if these cells will be targeted against our own body components, or our own body components will be treated as a non-cell, then this is quite a dangerous condition. And there is a term which is used for it, is autoimmunity, where the immune system gets triggered against our own components. So these self antigens have to be removed from our body, so they are removed by the process of apoptosis. So these are only the cells which are active against the non-self antigens. Other antigens are being removed. Another use is actually the organ size management. See, this is the larger size, and the excess cells are removed by the process of apoptosis. This is also involved in the tissue remodeling, whereby the cells which are no longer required, they are removed. Like for example, this is the resting lymphocyte. Okay, then these, some of the cells, they are involved in the fighting against the infection, but when the infection subsides, then these cells have to be removed by the process of apoptosis. This I've told you, self antigen recognizing cells, they are removed, and this process is known as clonal deletion. So what is the significance? You can understand by this sentence that our human body makes around 100 million lymphocytes every day, right? And if so many cells have to live without dying, then what will happen? This will lead to a condition called leukemia. So that is why this apoptosis is so important. Further, the B cells that do not encounter the stimulating antigens, they send the signals to the phagocytes for their self destruction and removal from the body. In the similar way, certain virus infected cells, these are all the endogenous antigens, means the antigens which are present inside our body. See, the virus gets entry into our body, it uses its our host cell, our machinery, cellular machinery, to synthesize its own components. So then it becomes the endogenous antigens, and they undergo the apoptosis to help prevent the further spread of the infection. So there are the two terms which are very important. The first is a clonal selection, and another one is a clonal deletion. If I say clonal selection, I've told you before that the B cells that encounter the stimulating antigen, they will only proliferate into large group of cells, right? So in a way to fight against the any kind of infection. But how actually our body is protected against the self antigens? That means why don't we produce antibodies against our own antigens? So this is actually done by means of a process called clonal deletion. This also I've told you that the B and T cells that react against the self antigens, they are destroyed well during the fetal development stage. The process is not known, but if it is not completely removed during the fetal development stage, it leads to a condition called autoimmune disorders or autoimmune diseases. Like you must have heard of, this is the common, the rheumatic arthritis, It is more common among the females. Lupus, systemic erythematosus, the rheumatic fever, psoriasis, these are all the autoimmune diseases when the antibodies, they attack the self components. So with this, we come to the end of the humoral immunity, and in the next lecture series, we'll talk about the cell-mediated immunity. So I hope that you all are safe and just enjoy studying at home. Thank you.